For nearly 30 years, Chairman Mao Zedong was the supreme ruler of the Chinese people. When he died on September 9, 1976, a new age began, with new leadership, new ideas, and dramatic new directions for the country. For the first time, economic prosperity was put before communist ideology. Never had a political culture changed so quickly. One more turn in China's permanent revolution. At Deng Xiaoping's direction, the most populous nation on the planet quickly became the number three economy in the world. With wealth came many of the trappings of the West: foreign investment, luxury, nightlife, and pop culture. Soon, even young Westerners began to pour into China for opportunity. In cities like Beijing, Shanghai, and Shenzhen, a new generation of ambitious business moguls, musicians, and artists flocked with the attitude that in today's China, anyone could win.
20 or 25 years ago, the leaders of China decided the only way to solve the country's huge problems of poverty was essentially to turn a big switch from off to on. Off in terms of private business development, of all sort of the dynamism of capitalism, they turned it on in basically all ways, just letting things happen. Open markets, stock exchange, IPOs, leverage buyouts, billionaires, Ferrari dealerships, private jets, all the things we would associate with just modern capitalism in its rawest form.
Changes happens every day in China. Not only talking about 15 years, in 1 year time, you will see a lot of buildings finished. They're really growing rapidly. In terms of people, lifestyle, okay, there are more and more people buying cars. These kind of people, they start enjoying their life. They're not only talking about whether I can have a full meal or whatever. They're talking about how to enjoy their life nowadays. We have some customers, they're a farmer. They have nothing, and then they work hard, and then now they come to a day that they can really afford to buy a Ferrari. The growing economy of China is rapidly, it's quick.
China has been changing so fast, and many Westerners still perceive China as it was 20 or 30 years ago. As China's GDP grows by 10% a year, the country's appearance and people's values have changed a lot.
The change is like dramatic. In some places you see like a construction yard, and around it a little slum, and then next to it is a nice new building. The city is becoming bigger and bigger and more modern too. I mean, now you see like one tall building after the next. Chinese people have seen a lot. Different kind of revolutions, first the communists, like against the Nationalist Party, and then the Cultural Revolution.
I don't think people really understand how fast things are actually moving. I woke up one morning and the bridge outside was gone. I came back the next morning and there was a new bridge in its place. We're not talking like no wood little bridge. We're talking like a 6-lane road, overpass, concrete, metal construction. That's how fast things in China are changing. It's changing like that. 7 years' time, I've seen 20 years of progress happen. Not just exterior, not just new buildings, we're talking like people's minds are being introduced to things that they've never seen before.